What's going on, everyone? Talon here with Talon Collects Figures, and we're back with another figure review. So, we're going to be taking a look at this Magik figure here from Kotobukiya. This is going to be the ArtFx line. It is a 1/10 scale, as you can see here. Marvel Now. And, yeah. So, I've had this figure in my collection for a while now, so this is going to be one that I've already opened and I've had on display for quite a while. I think I got her like, I don't know, like four years ago, 5 years ago, something like that. So I've had her for a while now. When I originally bought her, I bought her from Big Bad Toy Store. I paid $40 for her. I think that was on sale, right? Because I can't remember, because I know the ArtFx line is their cheaper line in terms of like kind of budget figures. But I don't remember if that was a sale price or not. But anyway, got it for 40 bucks. And yeah, I've been on display for a while. I've been looking for a good replacement for her because I'm just not a fan of the 1/10 scale, or just, I guess, how the faces look at that scale. It seems like a little too small, so the details don't pop very well. Or maybe it's because I have them displayed in kind of like a corner cabinet, so that size doesn't just display very well. Whatever it is, I was just looking for a different Magik figure, and I finally found that in terms of the Iron Studios Magik. So she is going to be getting replaced with the Iron Studios Magik, so that's why I'm actually selling her. So I'm going to make this video before I sell her off so that I have this as kind of a review on the channel here. But now we can take a look. She is right here in the back. So here is the figure herself. I said I paid $40. When did this figure came out? It came out in January of 2016, so quite an old figure now. After eBay sales and taxes and fees and shipping and all of that, I sold her for, it was 60 bucks, I believe. So I actually ended up making a profit on her. I mean, that wasn't really my intention, but at least she held her value and I was able to get back out what I paid for her. But as you can see, here is the figure, which when you're up close, she does look really good. It's just always at a distance. I don't know. I just didn't really like the figure as much, I guess, maybe how I had her displayed, or you need to be up close to kind of really appreciate the detail on the figure. And the sword does kind of look a little cheapish, like kind of flimsy, but then again, the one from Iron Studios also ended up looking kind of cheap and flimsy. So here we go. We can take her off of here. It's just a magnetic base. You can see the sword is just propped underneath her like that. That'll focus. There we go. I don't know. I think this sword might actually look better than the one from Iron Studios, because that one just looks kind of flimsy, plasticky, and not well painted. This one looks a little bit better. Pull her off here, get a closer look. So again, it's what you would expect from kind of a budget line of figures. You know, the quality is good for the price that you're paying, because I don't remember. I think her retail price might have been like 50 or 60 bucks. So I guess she technically went up in value if I was able to sell her for a little bit higher than that. But yeah, you can see there, pretty nice. Her base, like I said, is magnetic, so she kind of just clamps right onto the base. Got the Marvel Now here. So overall, a solid figure for a nice a budget Magik, because there's not actually a lot of Magik figures out there. I mean, there's basically like two, like this 1/10 scale, the Iron Studios 1/10 scale, and then there's one by, oh, I always forget the studio's name. It's a 1/4 scale, or actually I think it's a 1/3 scale statue, so it's a huge Magik figure, and it's just super expensive as well. It's like a grand or something like that. Can't remember who makes, oh, I think it's Infinity or something like that is the name of the studio. But yeah, that figure looks amazing. If I had the budget to buy that, I would definitely try to get my hands on it, but of course sold out everywhere. It was never imported to the US, so there's never really a chance to buy it here. We have to import it from out of state, or not out of state, out of country. So yeah, but anyway, that was a, this is a quick little look at Magik here before I, like I said, ship her off to her new home. Okay, and yeah, I guess that's gonna be it for this video here. Let me know if you have her in your collection, if you're happy with her, or if you have any of the other Magik figures out there. I was almost tempted to get like maybe a garage kit or something like that to try to do like a custom one, but we'll see. I'm trying to get into painting, so maybe I can 3D print one and then paint one myself. We'll see if that's going to be something I can do in the future here. If you're interested in seeing any of that on the channel, me, you know, going through the learning process, because I've never painted a single figure in my life, miniature or otherwise, so I'd be going into a completely new. So if you want to follow along on that journey, let me know in the comments below. But that's going to be it for this one. Hopefully you enjoyed, and of course I will catch you in the next one.